What's going on, guys? So today we're out here at Ron Hoover RV and Marine in Corpus Christi, Texas, and we're gonna take a look at this brand new Flagstaff Classic travel trailer. This thing is simply enormous. Beautiful, beautiful travel trailer. It's got a lot of really cool features. I think you're gonna enjoy it. Hang tight, I'll be right back. All right, so let's quickly take a look at the numbers on this unit. This is going to have a gross vehicle weight rating, relatively heavy, 11,320 pounds. Has a cargo capacity of 1,608 pounds. So it has a relatively light cargo capacity, but a relatively heavy GVWR. This, in my opinion, is something you're absolutely going to want to tow with a properly equipped 3/4 ton or 1 ton truck. Very, very tall, very long. It has 4 slides, 3 on this side, 1 on the other side. This thing is simply massive. Has the ground control electric leveling system as well from LCI, so you have leveling pads up front here and on the back, and they also work in conjunction with this front jack, which is also powered, of course. You have 2 40-pound propane cans, and it has a double battery box. Coming around, this is likely going to be your bedroom because this is usually storage underneath your bed. Nice thick baggage doors with slam latches. On this side, you have your sewer connections over here, low point drain. Your low point drain is generally meant to drain your water system from the inside, especially if you're going to be winterizing your coach and you just want to make sure that you don't have water that's being suctioned into your pipe. So that kind of relieves the pressure, drains the water out. Schwintech slide here, you have a rack and pinion slide back there, and this rides on a 12-inch I-beam. So very large I-beam structure for this coach. This is going to have dual torsion suspension, and it runs Goodyear Endurance tires. So you won't need to do much in terms of upgrades there for a while. You have another connection back here to a gray tank, and then there's the back of your leveling system. Coming around back, 50 amp connection here. Here's your third slide, which is also rack and pinion on this side. LED lighting. Up top, it is wired for a Furion wireless backup camera, LED lighting up top, and it does have a full walk-on roof. Plus, it does have frameless windows all the way around. Here's all your water connections back here, outside shower. Sorry, they're doing road construction right down from me. That's very nice as well, another outside water connection. Interesting why they would have this here and they'd have this here. This is going to be for a barbecue grill that swings around. Then you have your outside kitchen as well. It does not have a sink, so that's kind of interesting. Has a cooktop here, has a refrigerator, nice cabinet space, nice thick baggage doors with dual slam latches as well. Very, very strong strut arms. This will be the outside of your furnace. This will be your water heater. And this also has a rack and pinion slide. You have your awning that comes off of the slide here, which is nice. That's going to be to winterize your refrigerator. Outside speakers. And then you have another awning right here. So I like when they put 2 awnings here as opposed to 1 that extends over the slide. This gives you more coverage, in my opinion. Place to mount a TV, plus cable and your power connections. Let's take a look inside of this Flagstaff 832 BWS. Everything's keyed alike, which is nice. So stepping inside, this is a very different floor plan than many travel trailers I've shown you. So you have your theater power seat here, which give you access to looking at the TV right there. Coming into the kitchen space, you have a huge wraparound dinette booth area here, which also turns into a bed. And it would be a relatively long bed, so you could easily sleep an adult there or tall teenagers. Good size island. You have your 12-volt Magic Chef good size refrigerator here, plus your TV, fireplace. Lots of pantry storage in here. You have a fair amount of countertop space here. on the island, and then additional countertop space back there for the coffee station. Now, I know a lot of people say, well, how do you put a coffee station here if there's no power? Typically, you're going to have power on the wall, or you'll have power underneath here. So even if you walk through certain units and you see that it doesn't look like there's a power connection right in front of you, oftentimes, if you look up, there's going to be a power connection or several of them underneath your counters. And that's how the Van Lee beacon that I've been reviewing for a while has it as well. Even though you don't see it here, it's usually up underneath there. Lots of drawers, countertop, cabinet space here as well. Let's take a look back here in this bunkhouse area. So this is a really nice bunkhouse. You have a love seat here, which folds out into a bed. You have a flip down bunk above. You have another bunk here, place for your TV, plenty of drawers, wardrobe space, very tall ceiling heights in here as well. This is a very well laid out bunkhouse. One of the nicer ones I've seen. I love the fact that the living room area also faces the TV. So you can sit in any of these seats here, plus the two theater seats, and you have full access to viewing your TV, which is really nice. A lot of RVs, travel trailers specifically, miss out in that area, and they'll put the TV up against a wall so everyone has to crane their neck to the right to be able to see it. But this is really nice. Now, not a big fan of the big gap above the door here going into the bathroom, but let's take a look inside the bathroom. Has a good amount of space right here, medicine cabinet there. Has this Aqua View shower miser system here. Plenty of headroom, so you could probably easily be upwards of probably over 6.5 feet tall and fit inside there. Nice space in here. And more space down here. They've done a good job of utilizing space in this RV, so you have access to things and they still give you storage. It might otherwise be dead space. Has that newer IRV Technologies panel here. I love this panel. The only thing I don't like about it is the fact that everything is so separate. I still wish like this one thing would be one switch with a slide out, slide in type button instead of having to kind of search around to find out what button controls what. Moving forward to the front bedroom. This has a queen size bed in it, but it can support a king size bed. You can see the space there. You have access to the bathroom. Very, very tall slide heights, which is nice. Lots of wardrobe space. Tons of wardrobe space. It all wraps around. This overhangs right here because when the bed is in, it tucks underneath there. Nice real doors for the bedroom. You have a place to put a TV up here, which is kind of interesting unless you put it on a swivel arm. I don't like that. Your connections are here, but if you're laying in bed, especially on that side, this is going to block part of your TV unless you pull the TV out. But then if somebody opens the door, they can hit the TV. I think the better location probably would have been right here and just have it kind of hang out right here. But still, you still run into the risk of possibly hitting your head on something. That's interesting. Maybe even put it up here at a slight angle. But I don't like it where it's at. Again, queen size bed. You have some storage above. Tons of storage in this unit. And lots of wardrobe space here. This is additional wardrobe space, or you can put a combo washer dryer unit in here as well, which is really nice. So there's a lot of storage in this unit. It's just all pretty much on the inside. There's not really anything outside. And you know, that's kind of an issue for me. I like the fact that they give you a really nice interior, but I think it's equally as important to give you access to stuff from the outside because, you know, quite often, most of the time you are RVing might be right outside of your RV and having places for your chairs, having places for your tables, you know, small cooktops, things like that is important. And I think having additional outside storage would be something they should try to work into this unit. Even if they had to do something interesting like elevate the floor slightly in the back, you know, turn some of the space right here into more of an outside access so you can put chairs and tables and things. Anyways, guys, I'd love to know your feedback. Please let me know what you think about this unit. This unit has an MSRP of slightly north of $55,000 and a sales price probably close to the low 40s or high 30s. Definitely want to give them a call to find out specifically. But guys, if you haven't had a chance, please take a moment, subscribe to my channel, give me a thumbs up, and we will talk to you again very soon.